All right, well, if you have your Bibles, let's go ahead and open those up to 2 Corinthians chapter 12. We're going to look at verse 9 together. 2 Corinthians chapter 12, verse 9. And we are talking this week about the greatest verses in the Bible in reference to trials. And, you know, trials are real. You know, so many believers in Jesus, and a lot of what we hear in Christendom today is talk about basically some preacher, some pastor telling people that if you do it my way, you'll never have to go through a trial. But truth be told, the Bible tells us from Genesis to Revelation that trials aren't something that we should necessarily be afraid of, because trials are God's method to train us. Trials are God's method to make us complete, to work on us. You know, he loves us. God loves you more than you know today. He loves you just the way you are, but he loves you too much to keep you that way. And one of the ways that he changes us is through trials. And look at here, 2 Corinthians chapter 12. This is where Paul the apostle, he's talking to us about this thorn in his flesh. You know, Paul was a follower of Jesus. He had been radically saved. He had cut off sin in his life. He was obeying the Lord. He was in the will of God. He was winning souls, and yet he still faced trials, right? He still did. He still faced trials. And the Bible tells us here in 2 Corinthians 12 that Paul asked the Lord in prayer to remove this thorn from his flesh, to remove this physical impediment from his life. But this was God's response. Maybe you're today saying, Lord, take trials away from my life. You know, the psalmist David said, he said, Lord, the Lord is my shepherd, Psalm 23, I shall not want. He leads me besides the still waters. Right? He restores my soul. He says, yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I'll fear no evil. Right? So often in Christendom today, Christians are seeing, oh no, there's your trial ahead. There's difficulty. That means I hide. No, of course not. No, of course not. As you walk through the valley of the shadow of death, you fear no evil because he is with you. The most fearful place to be is moving away from God, is beginning to do things your own way. It's foolishness. It's foolishness. And Paul here understood, listen, Lord, I'm going to plead with you to remove this thorn, but then I'm going to listen to what you would say in response. And listen to what God said to Paul. 2 Corinthians 12, verse 9, he says, and he said to me, my grace, my charis, my unconditional love, right? My unmerited favor upon your life, my grace is sufficient for you. You know, after the disciples had gone in, they had cast out demons. Jesus had sent them out and they were used mightily. When they came back, Jesus said, don't rejoice. Don't rejoice that demons are subject to you in my name, but rejoice that your name is in the Lamb's book of life. What does that mean? It means rejoice in my grace. Rejoice that I've saved you. Don't worry about the trials and all these things. That's God's job. God is working on you. God is going to do what God is going to do. But your job is to realize, God, your grace is sufficient for me. The fact that my eyes are open and I'm a child of God, my life is better than I deserve. And Lord, I want to serve you with my life. I want to live for you. I don't want to count my life dear unto myself, but I want to finish my race with joy to testify of the gospel of the grace of God. This is the scriptures. He says, my grace is sufficient for you, for my strength is made perfect in weakness. And Paul says, therefore, most gladly, I will rather boast in my infirmities that the power of Christ may rest upon me. You know, when you and I go through a trial, but we stay the course, we persevere, we resist, submit to God, resist the devil, and he flees from us, we don't allow him to turn a trial into a temptation. Remember, we talked about a few devotions ago, the word trial and the word temptation are the same word in the Greek. So when we're going through a trial, you know, Paul was going through a trial here, and the Spirit of God was saying, seek me, run to me, hear my word. You know, be involved in the things of my kingdom, right? Stay the course. And the enemy was saying, God doesn't love you. you have a thorn in your flesh because when you were a little boy, you did this thing wrong. Or 10 years ago, God saw what you did, so now he's judging you. That's the enemy. That's the Satan. That's the condemner. That's the accuser of the brethren. But when we do this, Paul says, even if I'm going through a trial and it results in weakness, he says, most gladly I boast in my infirmities that the power of Christ may rest upon me, that God's power may flow in and flow through me. You know, if you don't persevere through trials, you'll never experience the power of God flowing through you. You never will. Every time the surge goes to happen and you're plugged into the Lord, every time the surge goes to happen, you'll go, ha, ha, you'll listen to the world and you'll unplug. You'll do it your own way and you'll miss out. You'll miss out. Stay the course. Whatever trial you're going through today, maybe you failed in a trial. Maybe you faltered. Maybe you lost confidence. Maybe you drew back. You fainted. All right, that's okay. When you fall down, pick something up. Realize, No, I took on the world's thinking. I need to think on what's true and what's lovely. I need to think on God's word. I need to not be conformed to the patterns of this world, but I need to be transformed by the renewing of my mind. I need to be in the word. I need to be at church. I need to be with the brethren. I need to be sharing the gospel. I need to keep the main thing. And boy, if you do that, you know, the Bible says those who trust in the Lord will never be put to shame. The Bible doesn't say those who trust in the world will never be put to shame. The Bible actually says those who trust in the world will be put to shame. But those who trust in the Lord, never, never. And we trust in the Lord not by doing what our hearts tell us, but we trust in the Lord by doing what God's word says, doing what God's word clearly teaches. So continue with him today. Father, bless your people. Encourage them in their walks with you. God, help them to walk with you. Help them to do what your word says, to realize a walk with you isn't what we think it is, but it's what you say it is, Lord. That we're not leading this walk, you're leading it. We're holding on to your hand. So Father, bless your people today. Encourage them in the things of you. Build them up, fill them with your spirit. Whatever trial they're facing today, may they learn what you're trying to teach them as quickly as possible. In Jesus' name, amen.